श्रीमती राहुल जाएगा for mass productivity, multiple productivity, at least for his own productivity. It may be self-centric or egocentric or geocentric or cosmocentric. Each and everybody, especially human being, he has the option to be irresponsible. Except the human beings, all the other species, they have their own innate programmed responsibility to contribute something for its own generations, as well as a symbiotic contribution to development of the various other similar species and other distinct species of the world. So there is a responsibility to be productive, and this productivity is there in nature. Number two, this productivity is there in all species except human beings. The third thing, a human being can have two extremities. One, to be over responsible are to be totally responsible. That extremity of over responsibility is like Atlas and Hercules story. A capable individual, he can take care of the whole universe. He is having two extremities. All the other limitations are there with nature and other subhuman species that they can execute only towards a limitation. They are very much bounded by their executive skill or executive reach. Whereas human being is having one flaw and one facility. What is the flaw? He can be irresponsible, sluggardish or self-centric. That is his flaw. And what is his facility or his force? The more he grows, he can take care of the whole mankind. He can have, you see, we are seeing a lot of people like Raghukula Deepa. Raghuthama is Rama's name. And Yadukuro Dharaka is Krishna's name. So a person can uplift his family, uplift his clan, uplift the society, uplift or create a very great renaissance in the whole world. So human being is having the possibility of having extended responsibility and impact, by which, depending upon that level, he can take care of any number of people. He can create an impact for thousands of years amidst thousands of millions of people. So a human being is having extreme negativity where he is irresponsible and useless, extreme positivity where he can take care of the universal development in his shoulder. These two possibilities are there with human beings. So regarding productivity, it is to be useful for some other thing. It may be productivity for a person through guidance, it may be by supply, it may be by service, it may be by margadarshana or some sort of guidance that we give, it may be by narration, it may be by teaching, it may be by provoking a person to do a work, it may be working, or it may be leading a person to work, or it may be organizing with a lot of people to do work. So productivity is of different types. A person who is thought productive, he is always thinking out of good things. I am known as thought productive. If I think about things which are needed and which are burning and emerging in the society or within myself or within my limited ambit. So thought productive is there. Then direction productive, I can lead others. Then deed productive, I can do something individually, collectively, I can lead others, or I can be obediently led by others. So giving obedience as well as having the power to control, both are very much essential in leadership. So that's how we are becoming productive in various sense. A person showing the way, a person giving something, a person asking the person to do something, or a person who is molding a person to be an able person to do something, everything is the part of productivity. So instructive productivity, instinctive productivity, conceptive productivity, dialogue or dialective productivity, instigative productivity, directive productivity, potential productivity, collective potentiality, then leadership productivity, innumerable ways we can be productive. And anybody is said to be a good producer. A cinema is produced by somebody. A person invests his money and he produces that. Likewise, a lot of people, they produce goods. And we want precision. We want quality. So whenever we produce something, we expect three things inside that. The durability, one. Number second is the quality. Third thing is richness, glamour or attraction. So whenever you see some cloth or something else, you want it to be attractive. You want it to be very novel. Second thing, you want it to be cost effective, or someday you are not minding about the price, provided that it is very attractive and it is having a fashionable competitive status in the growing society market. So you want something with quality. You want something with enrichment. You want something with good durability. This is there in everywhere. The wear that you wear and the utensils that we use and various other tools or devices that we use, we are looking for warranty, we are looking for the company and the brand, we are looking for the configuration. So in mechanics, in electronics, in our own various other environmental living, whenever we want to construct a house, we want to go for quality. Quality cement, quality brick, quality concrete, quality meshwork, quality wire work, quality network. In each and every walk of life, we go for quality, we go for precision, we go for durability, novelty and attraction. And number two, not only with these things, now they have developed this type of breeding in living beings also. Quality development and quality breeding. If it is there in non-living beings or in sentient things, it is known as quality development. Quality control, maintenance, development and superspection. That is there in non-living beings, like the cement, like the gradation, like ISI and other things. They are with to quality control, quality maintenance, then quality equipping things and also quality superspection or inspection. So this is the area of non-living things. Quality development, totally it is known as. Whereas in living beings, it is known as quality breeding. Because what is the difference between development and breeding? Wherever there is a corollary, parallel contribution, that is known as breeding. Wherever that is a unilateral contribution, that is known as development. For example, if there is a scientist who is developing something in the form of a brick or concrete, only the consciousness of the person who is doing the work is working. There is no consciousness response. There is only the structural or embedded programming response of the concrete. If you are developing some concrete, concrete is